Take the crown, drag them down. Take the crown to show them how.
We're taking the crowns, break them down. Hang them on the bedroom wall. We're dancing with bloodhounds through the town. Banging on padlock doors. And we're singing like, oh, 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 oh. Save to the sinners, save to the sinners. And we're coming for you, oh.
Is about to freeze over as Chris Jones sees action for the XCW Championship against ACT. The one problem for ACT, it's Full Metal Madness, a match that Chris Jones has never lost. Will it be Chris Jones's night to take the XCW Championship back to EDW, or will ACT finally give Chris Jones his first ever Full Metal Madness loss? Also in action tonight, Hunter Halkin, the student, Corey Lee, the teacher. These two go head to head tonight. Who will come out victorious? Plus, Flesh and Miano Diaz get into it at the VCAs, with the challenge being laid out for Cold Day in Hell. Will Miano Diaz actually follow through with the challenge, or is Flesh gonna get this one by default? Plus, see Brogan O'Shea in action against James Cerebral for both the EBW and XCW Hardcore Championships, and much, much more, as XCW proudly presents Cold Day in Hell.
Welcome, 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 XCW Galaxy. Here we are starting it off right at a Cold Day in Hell. JJ, as always, accompanied by Eric Blackheart. Good to be here, good to be here. The first show of the 21st season?
Wow. Can you believe it? XCW's old enough to drink. And we've got you a stacked card for today. I tell you something, JJ, you would have to be a real boob to miss this show.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Hey, we got a big main event tonight for the XCW Championship Full Metal Madness. ACT is going to defend his championship against Chris Jones, a match I never thought I would see in 21 years of XCW.
Not at all, not at all. And definitely one we didn't expect, seeing as Chris Jones doesn't really wrestle too much anymore, but if you want something done, you got to get it done yourself,
I guess. I guess so. Also tonight, Corey Lee will be in action against Hunter Halkin, a match made at the VCAs. It's really kind of student versus teacher. I'm kind of excited to see how that match is going to go tonight. But we're going to open things up tonight with a five-way match for a shot at the New Age Championship later in this very show. Is Evan Phoenix, Jackson Law, Jay Ellis, Brandon Hobbs, and a mystery person we don't even know yet.
Okay. Okay.
Is going to be in this match, so let's get right to it right now.
Go.
The following match is New Age Open, where the winner of this match will be the number one contender for the New Age title being defended later on this evening. Challenger. Introducing the fourth challenger.
Oh, wait a minute.
Uh-oh, hang on. I know this guy.
Saw him hack the planet.
And introducing the final challenge.
debut for only a short time for the first time.
He was very pivotal in that storyline with Vengeance.
Oh yes, back in the day.
Back in the day. He is extremely pivotal. You notice how only two people are in the ring at the moment.
100%, but maybe they're the smart ones, I don't know.
Yeah, everybody else is picking and choosing their spot. Another participant will jump into the match.
Got a little gauntlet style. It's very interesting. I like.
Oh, what is this? Look at this! Big shoulder block by Brandon Hobbs to Jay Ellis as Jesse Justice making his way out to the ring. The New Age Champion has a vested interest in this.
I would say so.
He's facing the winner of this match later tonight here at Cold A&L.
Trying to get in ahead of his opponent, something he's very good at.
It's very true.
As we continue this gauntlet style match here, I wonder who's going to be the first to be eliminated and the next to go in. It's Jesse taunting everyone around the ring. Crowd getting behind Jay Ellis here.
Remember, once an elimination occurs, somebody else will jump into the match. Falling headbutt there by Hobbs.
And Hobbs keeping him down on the ground.
Yeah, he's in firm control. Is Hobbs going to go for it? Oh my God, is he really going to go for this? Oh no.
No sir, not today.
Oh!
Jay Ellis sees the opportunity.
Careful not to be doing that in front of Festus, yeah.
Get back in the ring.
Festus doesn't take any guff.
Not at all. We've seen him get a little violent last year. Same with Steve-O. These refs, I wouldn't mess with them.
No, I wouldn't either. XCW is the toughest referees in the business, I'll tell you that.
100%, yes, sir. I'll stand by that.
Oh, my God!
Again, look at that, but wait a minute, Jay Ellis.
Jay Ellis got out of the way of it.
Jesse Justice looking unimpressed as he's walking around the ring.
I wouldn't either. I wouldn't be impressed.
They always have to cheat.
Cheating? Not a fan of cheating.
Not a fan of cheating. No. Oh my God! Big cutter there by Jay Ellis.
Took him to the depths. Jay Ellis.
Into the corner. Well, maybe. Nope, off the ropes. Jell's coming in. Big cross body there by Jay Ellis.
Oh, baby. Jay Ellis.
Pulls him away from the ropes. Just to cover two and no. Jackson Law able to get that shoulder up. It's all about getting that shot at that New Age Championship later tonight. Jesse Justice watching this very closely. Scouting who could possibly be facing him later tonight.
Jay Ellis making a good case so far. They already won elimination and doing pretty well on Jackson Law.
He does still have to get through three more people, including the man he's in the ring with, Jackson Law.
Very true.
And Dead ID coming up. Might not be happening now if Jackson Law can get this cover. One, two, and no! Jay Ellis kicked out of the Dead ID.
Man, right at the end. That doesn't happen often, ladies and gentlemen. That's normally a pretty punishing move there.
Yeah, no doubt. Jackson Law has put away many people with that maneuver. But he He could not get it done against Jay Ellis. He's going to have to try something else.
Hey, that's how it goes, ladies and gentlemen. And Oak Jackson looking a little angry here. We know they've had a lot of bad blood last year.
Remember, these two have a history, too.
Oh, yeah.
But around this time last year, it was Law against Ellis.
Yes, sir. And it got brutal.
It got very brutal. Weaponry involved, I remember. Good job by Jackson Law.
100% Jackson Law taking back control here. And oh,
that's enough. One, two, and Jay Ellis. Beautiful ring awareness there by Jay Ellis to get his hand on the rope to break that pinfall.
Sir Jesse Justice nodding his head in approval there as Jackson Law did pin him a little close to the ropes, but hey.
Kick to the midsection, and now what? Oh my God.
I like it.
Me?
I don't like it.
No. Not the package pile driver. Package pile driver, my God.
Good Lord, Jay Ellis.
Oh, it could be academic. It's academic. That is it for Jay Ellis.
Oh, buddy.
And here comes the wild card, Desmond Cross. I feel like nobody's going to be prepared for him, and Jackson Law certainly wasn't. Turned right around and hit some forearms. And now Cross going up to that second rope. What's he thinking here? Could be Tornado. Double underhook Tornado.
And it is.
DDT. Cover one, two, and no. That was so close that I would consider it an upset if Desmond Cross took this match and went on to face Jesse Justice later on for that New Age Championship.
100% a lot of vets in this match. He's still got Jesse Justice to go later, like you said, if he wins. Evan Phoenix in this match, and not to mention Jackson Law.
That's right. He's got to find a way to get rid of Jackson Law. Oh, another!
Oh!
Double underhook. Future Shock DDT.
Serving him up today.
These two really aren't a stranger to the guy. As I pointed out before, Desmond Cross has been performing in CBW for a little bit of time. So they're no strangers to each other. They definitely had a little bit of in-ring experience together. But Desmond Cross really, oh man, until that point, Desmond was really taking it to him.
Well, at least we know Jesse Justice probably is going to interfere in the match. He's not a big fan of the cheating, so.
Lost favor in that right leg. I don't know about that.
The old Jesse, not anymore. This is the no.
Wow.
Big hit.
What a right hand that was by Jackson Law. He's essentially a one-legged man in an ass-kicking contest right now. Oh my God, flattening Desmond Cross, and somehow Desmond Cross found the wherewithal to kick out. And Jackson's got to be wondering, what in the hell does he have to do to put this young kid away?
Jackson's mobility hampered here, but not totally taken out. It's definitely aiding him here. If he couldn't walk, this match would definitely be Desmond's for now. But
look at Jackson getting in Cross's face. Come on.
Only wonder what smack he's talking there.
I have no idea, but it can't be good. And look, I think it's made Desmond mad. He's backed him into the corner here.
Uh-oh, going for it again, possibly?
What in the world?
He's serving up DDTs like they're hamburgers today.
Another one, nope. Went to the well too many times, and Jackson Law has him scouted. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, not this time.
Oh my God, big power slam. Oh no, my God! Cover two, and that's it for Desmond Cross. And that leaves just Evan Phoenix to contend with now. And he rolls right in and gets right to work on that bad foot. Evan Phoenix, very smart, targeting the bad foot of Jackson Law.
Hey, even if Jackson wins this, he's going to be at a severe disadvantage, already eliminating two opponents. He already looks gassed. And Evan Phoenix, like you said, not helping that whatsoever.
Well, Evan Phoenix definitely has the experience advantage as he grapevines that leg. Jesse liking what he sees here.
I don't think he's going to make it out of this. I don't know.
It's going to be real tough. Jackson Law doesn't have very many avenues to get out of this. He's got to try to get to the ropes. He's got to try to roll out of this.
He might be able to roll out of it if he's lucky.
Big kick.
Oh, wait a minute. Here
and
we go.
One.
Okay, I'll give it to him.
Yeah, but you don't know what damage that did to Jackson Law. Is he going to be able to stand? Is he going to be able to hit the dead eye knee? We don't know.
Not going to give him a chance.
Right back on it again with another ankle lock. Jackson may not have a choice here. He may have to give up.
Oh, he's about to break it off. Oh my God, he's not taking no for an answer today.
Jackson Law shoves him away. Evan Phoenix not even giving him a moment to breathe. Evan wants that New Age title shot. He needs it.
100%.
DDT to the foot, my God.
It almost makes you feel bad for Jackson Law. Almost,
no,
almost.
No.
Slightly.
Don't go there.
Maybe. Okay, maybe not. Maybe that was too much.
Covered by Evan Phoenix, and Jackson kicks out.
Kudos to Jackson, though, for keeping in the match. Definitely, I'm sure he's got to be in a world of pain right now.
He's showing a lot of gumption for a one-legged man right now, and this is just torture for him at this moment.
About to say, he just keeps breaking free.
I'd be interested to see if Jackson can just even get to a vertical base right now. He's got to be hurting for certain.
Even if he pins Evan Phoenix, Jesse Justice probably going to have an easy time tonight.
Look at this. On one foot. He couldn't even do anything.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Yeah, Jackson's foot might be done.
It looks like this may be Evan Phoenix versus Jesse Justice tonight.
It's looking that way.
Jackson, he's going to have to make something big happen here. Can't really walk.
Just dragging a helpless Jackson Law over to the ropes. We know what he's about to do. We've seen it a million times. He's gonna make it a million and one right now.
Somebody call the police. What if it is the police you're about to do a drive-by to?
Then it's Detroit. Oh my God!
Oh man, Jackson Law, lights are on. Nobody's home.
Yeah, that was a hell of a drive-by.
Oh!
Somehow, I cannot believe this man's still kicking out after all the damage that he has suffered. Whether you love or hate Jackson Law, you have to respect the courageousness that he is showing right here to continue on such a bad wheel. I cannot believe he's still in this match.
If I was a betting man, I would have lost my money right there. That is for sure.
I wouldn't withdraw that bet just yet. Oh! Jackson almost didn't even make it to the turnbuckle. That's how bad his foot is.
Almost looked.
Oh, and then that though. Big trip there, sending Evan headfirst into the turnbuckle. Now Jackson Law's got to try to find a way to capitalize. I don't know how he's going to do that on a bad wheel. He's very clearly favoring it.
Yeah, he's limping pretty badly. He can at least still get
it
around.
Look at Jesse Justice stopping him from taking the turnbuckle back.
That's
off.
Right. That's what I'm talking about. A little order here.
Oh, wait a minute. Jackson better not turn around. Look out. Palomas kicked by Evan Phoenix. Right on the mark. This could be enough if he can cover him here. Cover. He got him.
He's done it.
There we go. The winner of the New Age Open and the number one contender for the XCW New Age title, Evan Phoenix.
Well, Eric, you didn't have the best year last year, but so far, Evan Phoenix, pretty good 2024.
Yeah, starting off on the right foot. I wish I could say the same for Jackson Law. But he's going to be facing Jesse Justice later on in this very broadcast for the New Age Championship. I cannot wait to see that match. It's going to be a banger. You won't want to miss it. We got more Cold Day in Hell heading your way. Stay tuned.
Ah, Justin, just the superstar I was looking for.
Superstar.
Yeah, the superstar.
Right. What the hell do you want, Danny?
I'm so sorry about your losses to IMF, the foundation, right? The big guys. I mean, I feel like someone like you and your stature and your ability could have stood up to him any day, but having to carry someone like Rob Slater with you all the time, it's got to be holding you back. So, buddy, can I call you buddy, pal?
Go on.
So, buddy, I have a proposition. Drop the non-essential one and join the elite, the best, former world champions, future world champions. It even has someone you brought to the wrestling world in Chris Jones, someone yourself.
Future and former world champions? I would fit in based on that moniker alone, but I'm going to go ahead and tuck this away and remind you that Rob and I, we did have a little bit of a comeback and beat Onyx and Jesse Justice. So
we
haven't quite lost our touch. But I've noticed someone's been on quite the losing streak and not able to hold gold. Okay. So if you want another, hold on, I'm not done. If you, buddy, pal, if you want another shot at some, holding some gold, then why don't you find a partner tonight to wear your wretched ass EBW crap and meet us in the ring. How about that?
Oh, I'm gonna make you regret those words. I have someone just in mind for you, Justin.
The following match is a tag team match scheduled for one fall, where the winners of the match will acquire the managerial services of Mistress Candy. Introducing the first their way to the ring.
That's my foot's messed up. I can't.
Yeah,
sadly.
As much as you want to.
I know.
And introducing their opponents.
The green face, JJ, but if you look at Candy's face, I don't think she's too happy about possibly not being able to be involved with the Unholy anymore. If they lose this match, they lose Candy.
It's just a surprise to be sure.
Definitely a crucial part of Unholy, I feel like. I know she doesn't wrestle, but
she's clearly not very thrilled about it. You can look at her face and see.
I wouldn't be. Hey, I just work
here. Yeah. I mean, would you be happy if you were on the line in a match? They were trying to give you away?
Mm-hmm.
Like a piece of meat?
I am a piece of meat.
Oh, that's fair.
You started them up. I'll start this one.
I would say you're a big, juicy Culver's burger.
Aw, thank you. Butterburger.
Sounds absolutely delicious right now.
It does. We're not sponsored by Culver's, I promise.
No, but I wish we were. Holy
God,
shit.
I wish we were. That'd be so freaking sweet.
Oh, man.
Anyway, we've got some action to commentate here. Looking like Julian Voigt Jacobs and Shane Shaw are going to start us off here. Shane Shaw.
Shane Shaw's about 3'5", so this isn't going to work. It's like if Jabba the Hutt were wrestling Yoda. That's basically what it reminds me of. Oh, my God! Turn Shane Shaw inside out.
100%. Spin cycling. See ya. He can do that.
Ain't nobody more worried right now about the Unholy than Candy, because if they lose, she's with them now. She'll be with the EBW hopefuls and not with the Unholy if they win this match. It's gonna be heartbreaking.
Do you think they'll finally be a part of the EBW?
I don't know.
DJ distracting the ref a little bit, allowing Shane Shaw to get the upper hand.
Yeah, believe me when I say Candy does not want to be ripped away from DJ Wahlberg or Shane Shaw.
I guess they better win then.
I guess they better win. Big side kick to the upper thigh of Julian Voigt Jacobs, taking him down like a big tree. And a big enziguri as well. My goodness. Shane Shaw really showing the improvement over the past few months. We saw a little bit of it at Encounters a few weeks back. We saw a little bit of it late last year, but he really seems to be coming into his own now.
Very true. If you haven't seen Encounters, go to YouTube, XC Wrestling 1, go find it.
There will be a new episode. It will return next Thursday right here on XC Wrestling 1. looking forward to that as DJ Wilbert is tagged in and immediately starts beating the absolute hell out of Jacobs. And a big slap to Mitchell Maverick, too, for Boo.
Yes, sir, 100%.
And a big Bronco Buster.
What to say? All of these men been a part of encounters as well. Good to see. Glad the regular season's back, though. I know.
I've been missing it. I think we're going to get a little this close here from DJ Wilbert as he climbs up on the back of Julie Wood Jacobs. There it is. This close.
100% hits it. Oh, man. This could be it.
Can I say, as we get a cover here, two and no. I just say, DJ's wardrobe choice is giving me seriously Edging Christian 2000 vibes. Do you see it? Because I see it.
I see it. I mean, Marilyn Manson. I see
that. That too. I was more referring to the mesh top. As Julie Boy Jacobs just caught DJ. Big FU! Oh, God. Can I get a replay on that, please? Holy moly. What a catch here by. Look at this.
Shit, I can watch
Mike
that.
Nothing. Just caught him, hoisted him up, and laid him out.
Hoisted. Now we got Mitchell Maverick getting a tag.
Back into live action, and now Mitchell Maverick going to do some damage with a big slowing drop. He let the beat drop.
I see what you did there, Beastie Boys.
Yeah.
Another punishing maneuver on DJ Wilbert. Thankfully, Shane Shaw there to help with the. Oh, ouch.
My name is Mike D, and I'm here to say Mitchell Maverick getting all up in Shane Shaw's face
today.
And a big, oh, he went for the fisherman suplex, but DJ blocked it. Oh, my God. Big swing and neck breaker there by DJ Wilbert, and now DJ's going to try to get the cover on. No, he's not. What's he doing? Oh, he's going to go up. No, he's going to roll in.
As he tagged Shane Shaw before he did it.
I was getting ready to say, he did tag Shane.
Good maneuver there.
And Mitchell Maverick immediately getting all over Shane Shaw's case.
Come on, Shane, get up!
He wants back in, he wants Shane.
DJ is really getting incensed at Shane Shaw.
I mean, this is what he got to lose here.
Yeah, he'd lose candy if they lose.
And it doesn't have to be his
fault. I would be mad too.
Yeah, it could be Shane's fault. Hey, but let's hope not. We've had tag teams break up for other reasons.
Oh my God. I mean, this tag team's already broken up once. How many times can the same team break up?
Don't ask that question, please.
My God.
Oh, baby.
The action has spilled out onto the floor here at ringside. Mitchell Maverick laying out Shane Shaw. Remember, the winners of this match retain Mistress Candy's managerial services. A prize that I guarantee you DJ Wahlberg does not want to lose. Trust me, if I had a hot girlfriend, I would not want to trade her for anything in the world. I guarantee that.
Not to mention Maverick and Boyd.
So I understand DJ's pain a little bit here.
Well, he's got to help Shane Shaw.
I can't believe I'm saying this, JJ, but I think I'm rooting for the unholy here.
Stranger things have happened. I'm definitely not rooting for EBW.
But I really don't know who to root for when it comes to this group. Tag into Boyd, tag into Wahlberg. Clothesline just takes down Wahlberg. Big shoulder block as well. Wahlberg is on the ropes. He's reeling.
He's trying to get away, but there's no escape.
Oh, my God. Look at the strength. Oh!
Straight into the canvas, plants him like a tree.
I think Wahlberg turned it into a DDT. Both men are down. The first man to his feet here is going to really be in the advantage here for this matchup. Mitchell trying to will his partner back into it.
Uh-oh. Yeah, DJ Wahlberg the first one.
I can't say that I like either of these teams, but yeah, I think I'm ready for the unholy here. If I have to.
Do we have to root for anybody?
We don't have to, I guess, but.
I'm going
to
abstain. I'm going to abstain from this.
I kind of feel bad for DJ in this one because he's gonna lose candy if he loses this match.
You gotta watch them open hands.
Yeah, disqualifications aren't gonna do him any favors either.
Oh, now what a way to lose too. Oh man,
that would be a terrible way to lose your manager. Big drop kick there from DJ Wahlberg. Yeah.
I think a toothpick.
I think so.
There it is. Yep. Found it. Goes for the cover and oh.
Yeah, I was about to say, way too close to that rope.
You gotta keep that tooth for your necklace, Jeffrey Dahmer?
Yeah, 100%. Don't talk about my tooth necklace.
All right, sorry.
They don't know about my tooth necklace. Julian Void Jacobs!
Listen, I've already showed you my tent collection.
It's very nice. It's very nice. Thank you.
Void cinching up for the suplex. Oh, my Lord.
Making it look easy. That's
just keep him up there for about a year and a half.
That's probably like a plastic doll to Void.
He started that suplex back when he started in 2017. Oh, my God. That's the strength of Julian Void Jacobs. No doubt about it.
Both of these men, really.
Both of these men have loads of strength.
Those Germans by Mitchell Maverick. Well, what's his face there?
Oh, look out. TJ Wahlberg ducked. Side rush and leg sweep.
The old switcheroo on him.
And both men are down. And I think TJ like desperately needs a tag. Needs to try to get a hold of Mitchell Maverick here. He's got to get back into this somehow. He's picking Mitchell off the floor. Look at this. Is he going to go for this?
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God!
Yes, sir!
Beautiful deadly driver there by DJ Wahlberg, and now he's going to go up to put the nail in the coffin.
Oh, I see what you did there. I see what you did there. I like it.
And a tag-in? Was that a tag-in? He tagged in Shane Shaw. I don't know what Shane Shaw is thinking. DJ kind of had it under control.
Uh-oh.
I smell trouble in paradise for the unholy.
You mess with the game plan, bad things happen.
I don't think DJ's too happy about this. Oh my God, look out.
Like you said, DJ kind of had it in the bag there. I'm not saying he would have won, but no!
Makes the Samoan drop by Mitchell Maverick. Here's the cover. One, two, and it's over.
Oh shit! Oh shit!
The winners of this match as a result of a pinfall, Julian Void Jacobs and Mitchell the Riot Maverick. All right.
Oh my God.
And
ladies and gentlemen.
Due to the stipulations of the match, Maverick and Jacobs
It's like a legal kidnapping, I feel like.
But that is the rules of the match. Mitchell Maverick and Julian Void Jacobs now have a brand new manager, Mistress Candy. And DJ Wahlberg is beside himself. He is livid and Shane Shaw.
He screwed a pooch on that one, Aaron.
I kind of feel bad for DJ Wahlberg here. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got more Cold Day in Hell right around the corner. Don't go anywhere.
Leon. I knew you were scared. I knew you'd duck out. I know just as much as you know that at TakeOver the World, not only am I taking over the world, but I'm taking over your career, and I'm going to absolutely end you and take that international. Just know that.
Well.
Yeah, well, Eric Mason was scheduled to face Leon Lux here tonight for the international championship. Of course, Leon's not here. We have no idea the status the international championship match, or if it'll even be happening here tonight. Questions that will hopefully be answered as we go. But right now we got some tag team action to get to, as the real ones are in action. So let's get right to that.
The following match is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the XCW Tag Team Championships. Defend those XCW Tag Team Championships. We saw earlier Brandy was trying to recruit these guys.
That didn't really work out too well for him, did it? did you really think that they were going to work with an EBW?
No, but I mean, it's for effort, I guess. You got to add on the shot.
Yeah.
But it is what it is, you know? It is what it is.
And introducing their opponents.
Speaking of in the corner, Justin Parsley backed into the corner here by Tommy Merriman. And Brady Branson with a cheap shot. JP isn't going to stand for that.
I mean, he kind of deserved it, though.
He did. He deserves that and a lot more. Remember, last year at Cold Day in Hell, Brady Branson became XCW champion. And we all know who he beat to make that happen.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I won't rub it in.
Yeah. I'm still a little sore from that.
Well, at least the championship, you know, notably absent from Brady Branson, so that's good at least.
Yes. In fact, ACP will be defending it later tonight in a Full Metal Madness against the leader, so to speak, of EVW, Chris Jones.
Yeah, I'd say so.
Last 2 years in a row, we've seen an XCW championship title change at Cold Day in Hell. Would this be three in a row here tonight? We'll have to find out.
You say three. The third time is the charm. Let's hope the opposite this time.
Let's hope ACT doesn't fall the way of Brady Branson 2 years ago and yours truly last year.
Yes, sir, I agree 100%. Especially at a crucial time like this, EBW does not need the championship.
it's still strange to me that this time last year I was XCW champion, and now I'm here with you, calling the fantastic action.
Yes, you are. Your first cold day officially as a commentator.
That's right.
Glad to see it. Our first full year together. Oh!
I will tell you, I'd rather be sitting here than going to a barbed wire table, that's for sure.
I bet. Now we have
Tommy Merriman in control here against JP. Tommy gonna go for that kill switch. He's got it locked in. Effortless. He made it look effortless, and there's the cover and only a two count.
Close.
The real ones are not gonna give up that easy.
No, sir.
It still blows my mind that Tommy Merriman is willing to work with Chris Jones, a man he nearly murdered 2 years ago when Chris Jones was XCW champion.
Also had plenty of good times back in the day as well.
I wouldn't consider a knife to the face a good time.
I mean, yeah, but they partied together.
I mean, we all saw that footage.
Girls together, all kinds of stuff. Back in the day, Chris Jones and Tommy Van Merriman, different people.
And incidentally, Chris Jones was XCW champion after a Full Metal Madness match against Venom at Halloween Harvest the October previous.
Didn't that guy get fired? Venom, I mean.
We're not going to discuss that. Tag into Brady Branson here.
He should be if he didn't say that, though. You know, he's my old table buddy. I respect him.
Yes. I have respect for Venom, which is why I'm asking him today.
Steve-O started his count, his first year full as a ref, you know?
I mean, seriously, he Fletch and Tommy kicked me and Deacon Storm's ass a few years ago. I'm not going to disrespect Venom. Brady Branson disrespecting Steve-O in the 10 count by staying outside of the ring as long as he possibly can.
Trying to, you know, make sure it's fine.
Can't win the title on a count out.
Two freshmen in. Finally back to the action here, and
Bob Slater trying to back him into the corner. There he is.
Big hits there.
You might think Brady Branson and Rob Slater are the same size, but in reality, Rob Slater is 73 feet tall. And then right there in that big double suplex. Covered by JP. Could he have him here? Two and no.
I know he looked about the same size as JP. It's just a trick of the camera.
Yes.
Camera magic.
It's all in the editing.
100%. Wow, JP in full control now. The real ones, this is where they want to be.
Absolutely. JP wants Brady.
Oh my God! I will shut up now. I will shut my mouth.
I don't think JP's going to be talking for about a year and a half. I think Brady has wired his jaw shut. Jesus Christ!
Dazed and confused.
It's like the truck heard me. Here's the replay. It's in super slow-mo for our benefit. Oh my God, that was right in the jaw. That was right in the jaw.
No teeth though, no teeth flying.
I don't think, JP's got no teeth left after that.
I was watching, believe
Brady
me.
Brady knocked them all out. Jesus, man.
Uh-oh. This can't be good.
Tommy Merriman gonna go for a ripcord powerbomb here on JP. If he can make it happen. Ripcord!
Good.
Apparently the truck, here it is. Truck didn't think so. Big ripcord up into the cyclone. Beautiful maneuver. I would be a lot more appreciative if Tommy Merriman wasn't wearing that t-shirt. And Steve-O being distracted by Brady Branson as Tommy Merriman works on JP in the corner, serving up the first plate of chops here in St. Paul tonight.
Definitely get their money's worth out of Tommy and Merriman, that is for sure. Tommy, a great addition to any roster.
I don't think it's any secret that Tommy Merriman is a top-tier talent, no matter who he's representing.
Of course.
It's just a shame that he's decided to forsake the company that made him a star and is wearing the EBW colors.
Hey, that's how it goes. You know, sometimes business is just business. I don't like it, but that's how it goes.
Tommy Merriman decided he wanted to meet the canvas up close and personal there.
Uh-oh.
JP with the crossface. Tommy's gonna try to roll him over here at the cover. There's a cover, there's a cover! 2, and JP had to break the hold to kick out. He had no choice.
100%. Great maneuver by Tommy there. I hate to say it, but EBW.
Yeah, and that is not the corner. That's not the corner JP wants to be in. Uh-oh.
Tommy and Brady working together like that, considering they beat the piss out of each other literally last year over the XCW title.
Oh yeah, 100%. You know,
in a sadistic madness first blood match, I might add. That was one of the bloodiest matches in XCW history. If you don't believe me, watch XCW 5 hosted by my broadcast partner.
Oh yes, yes, yes. Very good one.
One of the bloodiest matches. By the way, I'm very honored to be included on that.
Yeah, it was a very bloody list.
It was a bloody list.
It was a very bloody list. Some of the matches, I was surprised. I distinctly
remember Tommy Merriman leaving a pile of Brady Branson's blood on the gym floor during that match. And now here they are, working together in EBW colors to try to win the tag titles. It's so mind-blowing to me. I am the king of having my back stabbed, though. You know that.
That's true. Unfortunately, I'm sorry to bring that up.
Fortunately, the latest culprit is no longer here. Big slap right to the face of JP.
I'll never stab you in the back. Don't worry, Eric.
I appreciate that. My back's been stabbed enough. It's starting to look like Sabu.
I don't see many spaces left, unfortunately.
No. Look at Brady Branson taunting Rob Slater. Taunting, trying to get into the real one's head here. It's ridiculous. Steve-O asserting his authority, and rightfully so.
Steve-O trying to get some order back in here. Good luck. EBW kind of likes to bend the rules a little bit.
Yeah, Steve-O's not going to allow that. Steve-O is quite consistently one of the best officials that we have. He's not going to take that line down. Rob Slater in. JP getting a much-needed rest as Slate. Oh, my God. Just knocked Tommy Merriman off the apron, and a big pip attack to the corner by Rob Slater. The essential one is in control here, and Brady Branson is in enemy territory, or enemy territory. And Tommy, this looks familiar. Tommy does this all the time. He did it when he was with Vengeance. He did it to me. If it weren't for him, I would have super kicked Fletch a third time and kept the tag titles for Heart of the Storm. But instead, Rob Slater goes headfirst into that brick wall, which is unforgiving. There might be an XCW logo over top of it, but that is absolutely no padding. And now Rob Slater has to count to 10 to get back in the ring, and JP trying to will him back in to this contest. XCW tag team titles on the line here in Cold Day in Hell. Slater trying to finally make his way back. Look out! Tommy Merriman, look out! Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh! What is the RKO? RKO out of nowhere! He hit him with the RKO on the outside! Tapped into JP! Brady Branson is still the legal man!
Oh shit!
Brady Branson is still the legal man! Don't forget, Tommy never tagged in!
I'm so confused! What's happening?
That's why I'm here, JP!
Oh my God!
That's why I'm here! Now Brady Branson on the outside!
This is madness right here. Holy. And these are the legal men, correct?
Yes, these two are the legal men. Okay. JP and Brady are the legal men. And Brady's got one less ball now, I think. Oh, my God, look out. Oh! Oh, small package driver. 1, 2, and no, Rob Slater rolls it over. Wait a minute.
What's going on? What?
The winners of this match, as a result of a pinfall, it's your XCW Tag Team Champions, Rob Slater and Jason Parsley.
Good eye on Steve-O, by the way, to wait to make sure that Brady's shoulders were down before making that three count. It's all by the book here. Trust me, Steve-O did not make a mistake. He wanted to make sure it was by the book. And it is by the book. And this is JP in the fight. Take down the tag title. You gotta think Chris Jones somewhere, staring him down, looking very menacing with his arms crossed somewhere, possibly in a corner. He can't be happy.
I wouldn't be.
He better concentrate on Alex Cardona Thompson. He's not to be taken lightly. Full Metal Madness later on. We've got more cold and hell headed your way right after this.
50%. If you are not bilingual, get the fuck up out of town for me when you ask me.
I told everybody there were Swiss awards. I told everybody in New Year's Nemesis, Miano Diaz, you're nothing but a fucking coward. Get your ass, now let's go.
They're gonna play his music again?
Ring
the bell. Okay, well, is it gonna be a count out? Have an easy win, I guess. Steve-O's starting to count. I mean, there's no Miano, so. I guarantee Flush did not want to win this way. If he wins this way, he did not want this. He wanted to put his hands on Miano Diaz, on the sauce.
That's what I'm saying.
I think the sauce has expired. Five count. What the hell? Wait a minute. Now hold on a second, he was fired.
That's what I thought.
That's what I thought too. What the hell is Venetian trying to do? No escape from this hell!
The following match is a winner-take-all match, and it is for
both the XCW Hardcore title and the EBW Championship. Introducing first.
Well, Trinity's the hell out of there. James Cerebral just laid out Brogan O'Shea with a cookie sheet, a steel. Oh my God! Oh my Lord!
He's already dead! He's already dead!
Brogan's already got one EBW championship away from their ranks.
I don't think Steve-O can start the match if one of the competitors has brain damage. I don't know.
Are we sure he didn't before?
Fair point.
Brogan just rolling slowly back into the ring, and Cerebral not letting it happen. The match, Steven's not going to ring the bell until both the men are in the ring. So all this extracurricular activity, it's only doing Cerebral good.
Extracurricular activity. Yes, this is a friendly game of dodgeball here.
Yeah, or dodge pan at this point.
I don't think there's much more of the pan left.
And Brogan's really not dodging it.
I could probably make a print of his face off the pan.
There we go. Now the bell has rung. Now the match has started.
Oh, now we're gonna...
Big Brooklyn leg drop by Cerebral. Remember, the hardcore title and the EBW title are both on the line. Brogan's already got the EBW championship. Can he get one more belt away from the orange and black? We're going to have to see here, but it's not looking too good at the present because Cerebral has really just beaten the absolute hell out of him. It's no worse than Brogan has gotten in the past from such people as Brady Branson. I still remember that match, that 2 out of 3, that 3 stages of hell match they had way back in the day. Oh my God, lemon juice and salt in the wounds. And
absolutely brutal.
It was tough to watch. Tough to watch. And Brogan O'Shea finally getting back into it. He's had enough of James Cerebral and his BS. EBW title and hardcore title both on the line. Because the hardcore title's on the line, that means anything goes.
Even murdering your opponent before the match.
That's right, yeah, apparently.
Allegedly.
Which is, again, kind of BS. As Brogan goes for the three-leaf clover here, I guess the EBW stands for extremely bullshit wrestling.
I think you didn't say that. You didn't say
that. Oh, God. Three-leaf clover, that was number two. Going for that third. Can he get it off?
A hundo!
It wraps him up for the pin, 2 and 0! The luck of the Irish was not on Brogan's side on that occasion.
No, it's not yet. It's not St. Patty's
Winner
Day yet.
Winner take all, two titles on the line. Somebody's going to walk out of this with the EBW title and the hardcore title. EBW, both of them are down.
EBW didn't have very good luck earlier with those tag titles, so.
EBW seems to be falling apart. What, with Hayden gone?
Oh,
we
no.
We don't know. Luke Blaze has gone missing. We don't know where Luke Blaze is.
Probably, I think he's in the woods somewhere trying to find himself.
Oh, my God! Big sky high there. Cover. 2 and 0.
Head smacks off the canvas there with authority. Brogan O'Shea. He's getting closer and closer to that 1-2-3, ladies and gentlemen.
I think Luke Blaze is in the Barbados trying to evade taxes at this point.
he's reached that point as the rich person arc, huh?
I think so. Brogan O'Shea back in control here.
Uh-oh. Brogan O'Shea.
Look at this. Oh my Lord! Oh my God!
See ya!
Cover, 2 and 0!
Oh man, he is really trying to put James Cerebral away, but unfortunately, that man just keeps kicking out. You can't keep him down.
Brogan O'Shea successfully applying the Dublin Driver to James Cerebral, but unable to make it a three count is now.
Oh, he's going
what
to grab.
What is Brogan going for here?
He's going to grab something.
A steel chair, always reliable, especially in a situation like this where the hardcore title is also on the line. Cerebral barely knows where he is. Oh! Regroup just in time to stop that from happening. Oh my god! Oh! And Brogan O'Shea getting the steel chair used against him. Ooh.
Big time hits there.
Yep. Hit him right in the nose. What is Cerebral thinking here?
Well, remember, ladies and gentlemen, xcwrestling1.wixsite.com/Shelbyville.
That's right.
It's our official.
On Facebook and Instagram, XCW Shelbyville, TikTok, and X, XC Wrestling 1. Oh my god, Roman got the chair up and a collision.
He said, chair be damned, he's going at it, baby.
Cover.
Oh man.
And Roman kicks out. Doesn't really surprise me considering the amount of abuse he normally takes. You're gonna have to do a lot to Brogan O'Shea to keep that man down.
I said both men have been hardcore champions.
That's true.
Those are hardcore matches.
And both men have been XCW champion.
Very true, very true. The only one's been EBW champion.
Yeah, that's true. Cerebral could be EBW champion here. If he can best Brogan O'Shea, he just did it with the Belfast Bulldog. Cerebral using Brogan O'Shea's own moves against him to try 100%. To win the EBW title back away from Brogan O'Shea, but it did not work on that exchange.
Brogan gonna hit him with the "How's my dictate" now. Make it home, that'd be funny.
I'd rather go through a potato famine than learn how that dictate.
I see what you did.
Chair right to the spine. Right to the spine of Brogan O'Shea, and now Cerebral setting up. What is this? I don't like the looks of this, JJ.
I bet Brogan's regretting picking that chair up now. Uh-oh.
No.
Oh, wait a minute.
I thought he was going to brain bust him.
He played the Uno reverse.
Last call on the chair. Cut it. For both titles. For both titles.
Why? You guys fucked up the spot and now have to go with them. Why?
This is all Shane Shaw's fault. This is all your fault, man. All your fault. You caused all of this chaos. You started all of this.
I didn't start nothing.
If I relied on you, if I wanted to, I could have got by Jaden Tucker. But guess what? I chose not to because of you.
Hey. You know what happens when you put your bitches on the line?
We take your bitches. And here, I heard you might need some therapy, so here's my business card. Now, if you want to come with us. Thanks.
Toodaloo.
Dude, I'm telling you, man. You're fucking this up for us, dude. Shane, I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you. Come on.
The following match is scheduled for one fall and is for the XCW New Age Championship.
So afraid that the world was gonna leave me behind. I didn't wanna wake up, I didn't wanna wake up, I didn't wanna wake up. I miss the misery.
Arizona,
We show you a little bit of earlier tonight here when Evan Phoenix is able to topple the New Age Open and challenge Jesse Justice. We'll show you that footage in a second.
And introducing the challenger.
This will be his first defense since then.
What a trip the New Age title has been on lately.
Absolutely.
Erica Mason to Jack Delta to Jesse Justice, and now possibly
Evan Phoenix if he could take the win here. Well, it just remains to be seen. These two are no strangers to each other.
Oh no.
They've been around the block a couple times. No doubt about it.
Should be red. Oh, comedy line shows wardrobe.
Remember, this iteration of the New Age Championship was initially presented to Jesse Justice when he was New Age Champion at the end of the 2021 season, 2022 season.
Yes, sir.
At the VCAs, as a matter of fact.
What a beautiful belt it is.
Yes.
Eric Mason held on to it most of last year.
Yes, he did. He was a very dominant force. Remains to be seen if he'll ever make it back to the New Age title picture, if he's on to bigger, better things. I mean, we still don't know. He was supposed to have an international title match. Of course, we still don't know the status of that. As far as I'm aware, Leon Lux is not in the building. He's never been in the building. I don't know where he is. Nobody knows.
So unfortunately, it looks like Eric Mason on the sidelines tonight.
It is very unfortunate for Eric Mason. He's a tremendous talent. And for him to not get a shot at the international championship is quite honestly tragic.
Green here is Evan Phoenix taking Jesse Justice down.
He's got Jesse Justice face down on the mat, working that arm. Look at this.
Oh, really locking it in there. Oh, buddy.
Uh-oh. I'm not even sure what to call that. It was like a key lock with the leg and a cover there by Jesse, but no. Evan Phoenix forced to relinquish the hold in order to kick out of that maneuver.
Good maneuver there.
We still have, after this match, we still have Corey Lee and Hunter Halkin to look forward to as well.
Oh, hell yeah.
And I am going to be super interested as to how that match plays out. Corey made the challenge at the VCAs back in December a very focused Hunter Halkin who has been losing matches lately.
A lot.
And I'm kind of wondering what Corey's game plan here is with Hunter Halkin. If he's trying to take him under his wing, that might be the case.
That's what it looked like to me, and they were definitely buddy-buddy at some point, and then a cold day, I don't know. Viewer's choice.
Yes, if you remember back at, I don't remember exactly what show it was, but it was back at Hunter's first match in this company, was against Corey Lee and Psycor, an attack match with yours truly, so.
So they
have a lot of history together.
100%, and to see it.
No Limits was the name of the show.
No,
I just remembered.
Look at you.
My brain still works from time to time. I am almost 40. Evan Phoenix coming in for the body splash, but Jesse Justice able to move out of the way. And now, Jesse Justice going to work here on the limbs, on the feet. Oh my goodness, just wrenching back on that foot. Trying to do to Evan Phoenix what Evan was doing to Jackson Law earlier tonight in the New Age Open.
Can't stop, won't stop here. Rope break.
Phoenix got to the ropes, and Jesse Justice, ever the fair competitor that he is, immediately relinquished the hold.
Cannot fault Jesse's methods here.
Quite a turn Jesse made ever since, you know, he's not frantic anymore. You know, Herbert seems to have.
No, he's a normal person. He will tell you he's a normal person. I don't know why anybody would think any different.
Yeah.
See, he just nodded to me like he. I didn't know he could hear us from over here.
And that was the old, this is the new Jesse. I like the new Jesse.
I like the new Jesse too. He's real focused. He's staying on his target. Look at this. Wrenching. Oh my goodness. That's an inverted Fujiwara armbar.
Look at that.
And he's got it in deep. And Evan Phoenix, that'll rotate. That'll tear your rotator cuff.
Uh-oh.
And now look at this. Evan Phoenix puts him in the ankle lock. That's the move that really sealed the deal for the New Age Open earlier tonight for Evan Phoenix. If he could get Jesse to tap here, he could have that New Age title. And Jesse is in the ropes. Finally.
Body.
Evan Phoenix forced to break the hold. And again, Evan let go this time immediately. Both of these two are being fair to each other.
Mutual respect. Yes,
absolutely. A very competitive matchup between these two for the New Age Championship here at Cold Day in Hell. We want to thank you for joining us, and we hope to see you again in 4 weeks' time as XCW tries to take over the world at the end of February.
100%. But don't forget, of course, episodes of Encounters before then, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned.
Yes, that's right.
Check into that YouTube channel. Don't miss those for sure.
Encounters airs every Thursday on XC Wrestling One here on YouTube. So be sure to tune in for that.
They're a near pinfall here as this match continues. Both men pretty evenly matched still.
Absolutely. Both men trying to get back to their feet. They're getting back to their feet at roughly the same time here, too. It is an even matchup. I said these two weren't strangers to each other. They're definitely not. They do know each other fairly well.
Oh.
I remember the classic battles between the Freedom Fighters and Lake Evil back in the day.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But unfortunately, only one can come out on top here. But it's anybody's guess who it's going to be.
That's true. New Age title on the line. Evan Phoenix, what's he thinking about? Oh, he's thinking about going to the top, and Jesse Justice saw that and cut him off immediately. And now Phoenix, I think he wrenched his knee, landing on the outside there. I think Evan might be hurt.
Uh-oh.
Wait. We got Jackson Ball. Jackson Ball's at ringside. He just hung Jesse Justice up.
Oh.
Are you kidding
man,
me?
Man, what a butthole. Jackson Law. I forgot it's a family show. I just want to curse. Comes out of nowhere and takes advantage of that distraction.
Evan Phoenix with the drive-by.
Uh-oh.
But he went here off of the... He's going to cap it.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! No,
thanks to Jackson Wall.
The winner of this match has resulted in a in the huge...
This time, you're going down.
Listen. Oh yeah, it's quiet because EBW is no longer in a position of power. You see, XCW now has not only our gold, but the gold of EBW. So not only am I champion of a company I only can't stand, but a company I'm not a part of, as well as bringing back the gold for XCW. You see, it doesn't matter who you are. If you're EBW, if you're XCW, you can fucking come and get them, all right? Because I haven't been afraid of a single person yet, nor am I gonna start now. Also, I heard that JX is gonna be here at Encounters, and so definitely I'm keeping my eye out. So stay tuned, XCW. There's a fucking war coming.
The following match is scheduled for one fall.
Both up in the moonlight, the
it'll immediately grow back.
Producing his opponent.
I can't really complain about the snow today because it is a cold day in hell. Makes sense. Someone should hear where this makes sense.
It's a cold day though. It's a cold day.
Now it's like 45 degrees. But still,
it's warm.
Corey Lee set to take on Hunter Howe. Can hear the challenge was laid out back at the BCA in December. Corey Lee had a hell of a 2023. He held the XCW title. He held the New Age title. Excuse me, the real world title, as he would have liked to call it. So Corey Lee, not having a bad year last year. We'll see if he starts out this year on a good fit. He's already trying to get in Hunter Hopkins' face. Look at Corey Lee smiling, smirking.
He's about to, he looks like he's about to discipline a child here. I don't know, I don't like the look on his face.
You ready?
Huh?
Bring the bell.
And they're already nose to nose here.
Somebody hit somebody.
I've been looking forward to this match. I've been looking forward to this match ever since it was announced at the VCAs. Oh my God. Yep. The offspring of a dog is what he just called Corey Lee there.
Oh.
Yep. Nice arm wrench by Hunter Halkin.
There we go. Let's see if the student has become the master here.
Hunter Hopkins not having a bad 2023 himself. He spent most of that year as international champion, only losing to Leon Lux near the end of the year. Nice drop call hold by Hunter Hopkins. I was trying to think of that name earlier when Lux was done. Front chancery by Hunter Hopkins.
Uh-oh.
Corey Lee trying to get to vertical base here. And Corey Lee reverses. Oh, side headlock by Corey Lee.
Oh,
hip toss down into the mat. He's got it cinched in, nice and tight.
Oh, that's how he likes it. Let's see if he's gonna be able to get out of this.
Some damn good mat wrestling here in the early goings of this matchup. Something not what I would have expected between these two, given the animosity between them. Side headlock to Stephen Halkin, and now he's got Corey Lee down on the mat. Receipt serves. Head scissors by Corey Lee. Beautiful counter. Hunter Halkin trying to get out of it. Headstand. Couldn't quite get it done there. Look at this. Look at this.
Oh, he's trying to.
Oh, there we go. Jackknife pin here. Two and Corey Lee able to kick out of that. Wow.
Now what a match this is, Eric. Oh man.
Wow.
Very.
You wouldn't know that Hunter Halkin is the student by looking at this. He looks more like the teacher here. Off the ropes with Corey Lee. Into the roll up. One, two, and no. Corey Lee able to kick out of that. I think Corey Lee.
Wow, he's got him on the ropes a little bit.
Needs to regroup a little bit here. Yeah, he's. Good boy. Played dead.
Corey Lee out of sorts here. Not usually the one on the run.
The student surpassing the teacher here. That's that Hunter Halkin just really got Corey Lee second guessing his strategy here. I think Corey Lee might have underestimated Hunter a little bit.
A little test of strength here.
Yep. Locking the fingers. And a stomp on the toe.
Buddy.
And another one. That hurt my toe. My whole foot, actually.
This is the first time we've seen these two go to war like this, but oh man.
Oh man.
It feels more brutal every time.
Alabama slam by Corey. And the back of it, Hunter Hawk's head bounces off the mat with tremendous force.
Yes, sir. Took him straight to the canvas. Uh-oh, he's got Hunter Halkin on the ropes now.
Oh! Oh my goodness. Working Hunter Halkin down into the corner. Now Corey Lee. Double knees.
Absolutely murders him with those. Oh!
No!
Hunter Halkin tries to hold on. Uh-oh, Corey Lee trying again and again, but still unable to get that three count. Taking a second to regroup here as Hunter Halkin still on the ground here, slow to get up. Wow, just starts to get back here, beat down again.
Hunter trying to smack some sense into himself here. Trying to knock the courage back into him. And the choke! Steve ain't gonna allow that!
I'm warning you!
I mean,
it doesn't do Corey any good if he gets disqualified.
You can't brag if you lose, technically.
Yeah.
One, two,
three. Hard to say you beat a man by disqualification.
Yeah.
Doesn't sound very good.
Yeah, not very manly.
Look at the good. Sure. Look at this. Corey Lee. With the shining wizard!
Takes him down!
That big death dealer. Cover. One, two, no!
He is all out of sorts here. Hunter Halkin rolled up like a piece of trash. Dazed and confused. And uh-oh, he's got to make something happen here. Corey Lee could come out on top.
Corey Lee's got him up. Oh, Hunter Halkin exploding out of the gate.
There we go. Off the ropes.
Corey Lee ducks the clothesline, ducks the back elbow. Northern Lights coming up. Oh my God!
Holy
what a power on that one,
Yankees.
Oh, wait a minute.
Another one.
Another one.
A minute. Hang on.
He's going to do it a third time? Wow.
Christ almighty.
Three back-to-back Northern Lights suplexes the cover with one arm, and Hunter kicks out. Well, Brogan has the three-leaf clover. I don't know what you would call that, but insane, I guess, to start.
I don't know. We'll have to go to the drawing board for that one, Eric. I don't know. But I'm surprised Hunter Halkin was able to kick out of that. Holy crap.
Insane. Those Northern Lights duplexes had to take air out of him. First man back to his feet here is going to have the advantage. No doubt about it.
Crowd.
Hunter almost back. Both men are dead even here.
Trying to get back to his feet. But
Corey Lee's back to his feet first, just barely, for a second. The right hand's being exchanged here.
Good old slobber knocker here. Let's see.
Oh! Government mule. Right hand. Hunter Halkin gonna go to the top rope, possibly?
Uh-oh.
Trying to get the crowd behind him. I think the crowd's already firmly behind him. Ain't nobody like Corey Lee. No matter if you're XCW or EBW.
Or his mama.
Oh my God, Lee! Oh!
Even the face!
Oh!
He ain't that. Big, oh, man!
Hit him with the big movie maker in midair, too!
Tenacity by Hunter Halkin, able to kick out.
Here it is again, this Hunter Halkin coming off that top rope. And Corey Lee catches him with the movie maker.
God
in midair. And somehow, Hunter Halkin is still in this. I cannot believe it.
gentlemen. My eyes don't believe. Oh,
cover. One, two, and no.
He can't be stopped!
He can't be stopped! What's it gonna take? Corey Lee's gotta be wondering that. What's it gonna take to keep Hunter Hafkin down? And I tell you, a lot! Hunter Hafkin was an underdog very early on in his career, and he's overcome that in spades.
He's gotta be running out of extra lives at this point, though. He's gotta make something happen soon.
Better enter that Konami code. Up, up, down, down, left, right, BA start.
Oh, I think he just did it for Corey Lee.
Oh!
Oh, no, wrong player. Oh, look at him just strung up there like a, you know, piece of laundry. Oh, he's rolling to the center. I like this, Eric. I don't like this at all.
Oh, no. The triumvirate about to happen here. Triumvirate! And he holds on.
Oh, buddy.
Is he going to do it a second time?
He is.
A second triumvirate.
One on a third. Why not?
A triumvirate of triumvirates? Oh my god!
Yes, sir! Somebody call the ambulance, he's dead. Call the coroner, he's
call
dead.
Him, yeah. It's over.
I'm just glad Hunter Hawkins' wife and children were here to see this.
Look at this, hold on. Look at this. Are
you even there? I like this way. Secrets to some town.
It's hard to love me. When is Corey ever respected anyone?
Say it! Say your right something. I'm Hunter Hawkins, motherfucker.
Oh my god.
Say it!
Just, Hunter, just say it, for God's sakes. Come on. He's gotta make this stop.
No, don't give up! Don't give up!
Come on. Enough is enough, Corey Lee. You've already won the match. Come on! What the hell is wrong with you? Corey Lee is an absolute bastard. Look at this! Oh, come on!
Why? Why?
Somebody stop this. Corey Lee is a psycho. He's unhinged. Come on. That's enough. For God's sakes. Here come
your God.
Festus and Steve-O are coming out to try to stop this. Oh my god!
What is Jackson Law? Should we get the police out here? Jesus Christ.
You think Jackson Law cares? I think Broken Fair O'Shea point. Just had flashbacks somewhere.
Fair point.
Jesus Christ!
Now I'm glad he does have a family.
That's a real fucked up thing to say.
Oh shit, yeah, that kind of does sound really bad when you play it back. I read that statement, my
this
bad.
Is enough is enough. Enough is enough.
I'm so glad the refs are doing so much to stop Corey Lee here.
This is ridiculous. Corey Lee is a psycho. This is absolute horseshit. Ladies and gentlemen, a big main event still to come. ACT taking on Chris Jones in Full Metal Madness for the XCW title. Stay with us, Cold Day in Hell. We'll be right back.
Yeah, everybody thought they was gonna make my match. No, no, no. I'm champion. I decide when I make matches. So, I'll make one right now. What should it be? One match. Oh, a Canadian lumberjack. And I'll start now! see you soon.
The following match is your XCW main event, and it is a Full Metal Madness match for the XCW Championship. Introducing first, your challenger.
I'ma worry about me, give a fuck about you, nigga, just as a reminder to myself. I wear every single chain, even when I'm in the house, cause we started from the bottom, now we're here.
Making his way to the ring. Coming in at a weight of 200 pounds. He hails from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Chris Jones, the man, the myth, the legend, a career spanning four decades. This is his, he informs me, 28th year of wrestling. That's almost as long as I've been alive.
Which is less than 3 decades. I don't know how that worked out.
I think it's like the 80s, 90s, 2000s. 2020s, 2010s, 2000s, and the 90s. So he started wrestling like 99, you know, right at the end.
That's Chris Jones, man. 28 years equals 4 decades. So that's neither here nor there.
Started in here.
Chris Jones making one of his contractually obligated appearances here to try to wrestle the XCW title away from ACT. Remember, the last time Chris Jones wrestled a Full Metal Madness match, he won it, and it was also for the XCW title. That was Halloween Harvest 2018.
Fun fact, Chris Jones has actually never lost a Full Metal Madness match. He's actually the one who created it.
My apologies, 2019.
He's been in one with XCW title on the line, his career on the line. Don't matter.
Making his way to the ring, he is your
That's pretty cool. I don't care who you are. That's crazy, right?
Metal Madness favors Chris Jones. Remember the last time he had a Full Metal Madness match was against Venom at Halloween Harvest 2019 for the XCW title, ending with an RKO on a Christmas tree, if you remember correctly.
I do.
Yeah, I remember.
Only weapons that are metal are allowed or have metal in them, so to speak.
Yep.
Like that Christmas tree.
Otherwise, there are no other rules, no disqualifications, no countouts.
Nope. Can't win by submission, though, I know that. You have to pin your opponent.
This match could go all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
Falls count anywhere.
It always does. We're going to have our work.
Oh! Immediately! Shit! Immediately a super kick!
Well, maybe it won't last very long.
That easy.
Chris Jones illustrating that he could have had ACT beat right there, but he's going to do more damage.
That definitely sounds like Chris Jones. You can't submit your opponent, but you have to pin your opponent. But like you said, Eric, you can do it anywhere. It could be in the bathroom, it could be in the stands, it could be... We could go to your house. I hope you don't drive that far, but...
That's a ways away.
Hey, who knows? Falls count anywhere.
I'm pretty sure the people I live with would be shocked.
Falls count anywhere.
This is true. Like I said, Chris Jones, this match favors him. I don't think he's ever lost one.
He hasn't. He told me he's never lost one.
So ACT has an uphill battle to climb here.
Yes, sir.
He created
the match, never lost it, and he is in firm control right now.
Absolutely he is. And already, Chris Jones headed to the outside, going to try to maybe get a hold of some weaponry here. Remember, it's got to have steel in it. That's a stapler. There's steel in it.
100%. Anything.
This isn't going to feel good. I'm not looking forward to the sound that's going to make.
Leaves the opportunity open for so many things, which is probably the point of the match.
Oh! And a forearm by ACT, thank God. Oh, wait a minute. I think Chris Jones is about to have it used against him.
Yeah, maybe not for Chris Jones. Uh-oh.
Oh, God. Look out.
Oh,
look
no.
At this. Oh, no.
Ah! Oh!
Keep going!
He did it!
God.
He did it! Oh!
go to 10.
Stapling his forehead. He's going to staple his shirt to the back. Oh, my God.
Just like a report for school, ACT.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
And he's making full use of that.
Oh, I bet Chris Jones is wishing he had a better hairline now.
Don't talk about that. That's a double whammy on me, too. Us old men, we're sensitive.
Hey, I don't care. He's ducked me for ages.
You're mad about that, aren't you?
I am a little. I'm a little incensed. I'm a little incensed. I'm rooting for ACT, don't get me wrong, but I'm a little incensed that he got to face Chris Jones before I did.
Year two of Chris Jones ducking Eric Blackheart.
Yeah.
Oh! He didn't duck that pan.
Oh! He's just lucky I'm hurt.
Unfortunately, I might play against us here because, as you said, we're probably going to have to get mobile.
I know, it sucks. Sucks for my foot. Oh!
Right in the G-lick.
That is a solid tongue to the ball.
Yes, sir.
Which I don't believe is a call I've ever had to make in wrestling before, but there you have it. There's a first time for everything.
Hey, at least he used tongs and not his hands. That's very sanitary.
He definitely tossed his salad there.
Oh, we keep going all day, I think.
Absolutely. The buffet is open for business.
The cheese grater.
And speaking of the buffet being open for business, here come the forks.
Uh-oh. Hope somebody's hungry.
Chris Jones doing his best Abdullah the Butcher impression. And now he's going to do his best Tommy Dreamer impression.
Uh-oh.
With the cheese grater. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Going to put that on his pasta later. Oh,
that's
my lanta.
That's no Gouda. Good Lord. Oh, man, I do not like the way that scraped across his forehead.
What is it?
That was nasty.
Like you said, open an impromptu little table here, sort of thing here with...
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't
obviously made of metal.
Chris Jones is just... When it's Full Metal Madness, the mind keeps working from Chris Jones. You don't know what he's going to have in mind. This is his match. He said it. He said as much in many interviews. This is his match type. This is his favorite type of match.
100%.
And he's been 100% successful at it thus far. So who the hell knows what the hell Chris Jones is thinking? And now ACT sees the destruction that Chris Jones was attempting to ring on ACT.
Oh, here we go, buddy. Somebody's going to go through this. Oh my man.
God. Oh, 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 my God. Oh, my God. The barbed wire stuck in his ass. I'm going to need to see that again.
And again? That might be on. I just might keep it on my phone.
That was one of the most satisfying things I've ever seen. And Chris Jones has now got a basketball goal. Here's this. First. Oh! Nothing but net. 2 points for ACT. Here's that suplex onto the chair again. My God. Folding that chair in half when Chris Jones lands tailbone first on it. And now back to live as ACT has the cheese grater. This is not going to be good for him. Not going to be good for Chris Jones. And now Chris Jones is going to know what it feels like. He's going to see what it tastes like. Oh, God! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Like fettuccine. Oh, my lanta.
Jesus.
This match brings it out of people. I'm telling you. Oh, man. The depravity. The sadistic...
Yeah, there's no end to what these two will do.
Wait, that doesn't have metal in
it. XCW title on the line, cover, River Falls, count anywhere, and it's a two count. Chris Jones able to make his way out of that. My God.
Looks like we're moving.
Look at this. They're heading over towards this wall. Oh, my God.
It looks like we're going down the hallway and we're going with it.
They're heading down the hallway here. What has ACT got? What is that? Oh! Oh! Oh, it's a clamp! He's got his nipple clamped! That's a nipple!
Jumper cables! Christ almighty! Well, it's part of a jumper cable.
Chris Jones about lost the nipple.
Oh no, it was a clamp! Oh my God!
Oh my Lord, yeah, that was a clamp!
Now we're going into the bathroom, I think. Oh, he's dragging Chris Jones to the toilet.
Oh! No, 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 no!
Not a swirly!
Oh,
ACT just gave Chris Jones a swirly.
This isn't grade school anymore, JJ.
California.
Oh my God! Chris Jones stumbling out of the locker, out of the men's room.
And now we're stumbling out. Maybe to the parking lot.
I hope not. That's insanity. Oh my God! We are going out to the parking lot. My God!
This is
you have no idea what you were in for tonight.
Why am I filming?
Leave that red car alone. That's fine. Oh my God! Head first into the truck.
Inception.
Oh man, this is insanity. I hope you're hearing this. Oh my God, metal pipe to the midsection. And Chris Jones absolutely getting the hell choked out of him here.
This is not what playgrounds are for, Eric. Why am I
filming? This is looking oddly familiar now. Remember the match between Corey Lee and Eric Mason. Not too long ago.
What? Hi.
ACT was just sent off the playground structure here. Now, Chris Jones, that's a little high up. No, you gotta be kidding me. Slippery, it's been raining out here. Oh my God, that was like 10 feet. Body splash cover, 1, 2, and no. I can't believe it. Yeah, that was a good like 10 feet just straight down, but Chris Jones knows no fear. Knows no fear. The temperature and the weather conditions are not going to be favorable. And Chris Jones already making his way back toward the arena, it looks like.
Thank God!
I'll wave him off. This is the next title match. He's not going to be able to just wave this off. And bounces his head off the fence post, my God. That's what I would have you think. Chris Jones walking towards the entrance to St. Paul Gym. ACT trying to get his bearings back.
Get the fuck out of the way!
Yeah, Chris Jones has gotten back in the building. ACT is following closely behind. Back down the hallway here. Oh, Chris Jones' head just went bounced off that brick wall.
And here we are stumbling back into the arena. We're back, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, we knew this was going to be insane, JJ. We knew it was going to be insane.
100%.
They're up in the stands. Look at this.
Now we're in the stands.
Look at what in the world. The XCW Galaxy's getting a nice up-close personal view of this.
They're going to the high-rent district.
They're all the way up at the top.
I don't like the look.
I don't like the look of this either. Oh my God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh Lord!
Bleachers! Jesus! Thankfully, didn't fall all the way into the. Into the arena, Christ, what, that's a tumble and a half right there.
Chris Jones just did his Q-bird impression.
He's just trying not to die right now.
Falling down the stairs does not help, I'll tell you that. 4.0 on the stands! 4.0! ACT could have him here if you could find a way to cover him here! Cover! False count anywhere! XCW title on the line! Holy moly, Chris Jones just fell up over here on the floor.
Confused.
For so long, it's not true.
I hear you over
ACT.
There.
ACT.
He's going back. Oh, he's.
What is he thinking?
Over there.
Is that a colander?
He's got a
colander. It's metal, steel, that it counts. That's going to make a hell of a noise. That's a hat.
And now it's a hat.
Now it's a hat. Now it's a big metal hat. Oh no. Oh God.
Christ almighty.
Oh God. No. Oh, this is insane. Even if, I don't care if it's TV7. Oh my God. Good Lord.
What the?
Jesus Christ.
I forgot. This is a family show.
Cover. 2. No.
What? How did Chris Jones kick out of that?
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. These guys are hitting each other with everything they got.
This is what Chris Jones wanted.
Yeah, it is. And he's getting it. He's getting an ass kicking is what he's getting. ACT tearing that EBW shirt off of Chris Jones. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Oh, God.
That's like torture.
I can't watch.
That's rough.
This, yeah, I can't. This is hard to watch. Not Jesus Christ.
Each man going to opposite sides. Oh, we've got a chain. We've got a walker. Uh-oh, old man Jones.
Chris Jones needs a walker. He's going to need a walker after this match.
ACT wrapping his fist in the chains. Oh,
oh my God.
Chris Jones just walks into it.
What in the world? Chris Jones is caught in that walker. The crowd is chanting for a frog splash. Are they going to get what they want? No! Oh my God! Oh my God! Frog splash in the walker! Cover one, two, no!
Unbelievable, Chris Jones! How did he kick out of that? How is he alive?
We get to see that frog splash again. Here it is. Oh my God!
Oh, they're coming up here with us, Eric.
I'm not sticking around. I don't know about you.
Contractually,
I'll watch. I'll watch from over here.
I was gonna say contractually we have to, but
I'll just stand over here where I'm safe.
I'll protect you. Don't worry. Just act.
What is this? Blade. Look at this.
Oh no!
Drop on the stage. This is wooden.
Right
wood,
into it.
No give.
And this is that good old wood.
Yeah, absolutely. This stage was probably built in the 1960s.
Yeah,
it's hard as a rock.
There's no give here.
This stage has seen more action than I have.
You and Steve-O combined.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a double whammy right there.
2+0 is still 2. Chris Jones got his arm wedged in that chair. And now ACT, they're trying to break Chris Jones' arm. And it's a damn shame he didn't.
Oh, Jesus,
sorry.
Oh, God.
Sorry.
Call me out
there.
We're
supposed to be unbiased. But, you know, I just cannot stand EBW and the way Chris Jones is conducting himself. He's kind of had this coming.
Hey, EBW. Yeah.
Don't do that. Oh! Damn!
He could win this year. This match, I mean. But it's looking like he might, because I think ACT might be dead.
ACT's going to have to change his name to CRT.
CRT? Jesus Christ!
Yeah! My God.
Chris Jones with one fell swoop. He's back in it.
Chris Jones picking up ACT off the floor. Oh no, look out, the colander. DDT on the colander.
Oh no.
Oh, they ran on the chiplets. You don't normally put meatballs in a colander. Chris Jones is doing it wrong. He's got ACT up. Head first into the steel post. Like, that's like the least of ACT's problems tonight.
All right, what a cold day in hell this has been.
Like, compared to everything else he's been hit with, the steel post must seem like a friggin' warm hug. And now, both men finally back into the ring after a lot of activity, and the Rough Rider! The Rough Rider by Chris Jones, and Chris Jones unable to capitalize all the damage that he's taken. The headshots, the back shots, the barbed wire, the steel pans, the body splash onto the walker. So much damage, and Chris Jones cannot capitalize. And it could come back to bite him in the ass later.
He said back shots. You said back shots.
Oh, super kick! Super kick!
Chris Jones pulling it all out here,
and
ladies
Chris Jones
and gentlemen.
With the cover! 1, 2, oh my God!
Oh, shit! Oh,
I forgot. This is a family show.
ACT kicked out of a super kick from Chris Jones! Somebody forgot to tell ACT he's only allowed to kick out of super kicks when I throw them. What in the hell is that? Oh, no, that's not the way. That shoe has got thumbtacks on it. Is he gonna super kick in with that? That's absolutely, to hell with that being a family show. That is fucking insane.
I agree. Oh man, oh, he put it on, there we go.
Come on. And look at ACT. Oh, he ducked.
Thank God.
Oh, and ACT is wide open. Oh my God, he kicked out again! What?
No way.
He kicked out again?
Holy shit.
Chris Jones just threw the best hit he had at ACT and it didn't work. And he even modified the best hit he had, and it still didn't work.
Oh,
what
has
Chris Jones got to do?
Pulled out. Oh, he's pulled out thumbtacks.
Oh,
he's got
jelly beans.
What the hell is that?
I don't think those are jelly beans.
Jelly beans.
Oh my God.
Well, he's already pulled out thumbtacks.
Jesus.
Quite a few of his repertoire.
Threw some of those our way.
No Illuminati DDT yet, but we've seen like the Frosty Float. I think that's what he calls the Rough Rider.
Don't give him any ideas.
Frosty Float.
Holy shit! ACT able to turn the tables and send Chris Jones into the thumbtacks! Never pull out the weapon. It gets used against you.
Oh, 100%.
Never. Oh, God. Look at
that. Oh, how the turntables.
Oh, Jesus. This is giving me Orton Foley vibes. 2004. Remember that? Oh, finale!
This could be it!
This could be it! 1, 2! Oh my God!
Oh, how many pinfalls have we had? Holy crap!
No, that deserves.
I don't think my voice is gonna make it to the end of this match, JJ.
Not? I'm surprised your voice has made it this far, to be quite honest.
Jesus. What's he doing here? And now Chris Jones is saying, bring it on. Hidden Blade! Could that finally be enough? Could it be enough? One,
much more
two,
than the tape.
He's done it!
Chris Jones at his own game.
Rents the title away from Vestas Davis. Look at this. EBW has absolutely no goal.
No goal.
But what is Chris Jones doing here?
Come on, Chris, do it. Yeah!
I was not expecting that, but that is a hell of a lot of respect that Chris Jones just showed our XCW champion ACT. What a hilarious. No, not now. It can't be. It can't happen now. No way. Here's Jesse Justice. Here comes Jesse Justice. Ah!
Yes!
Thank God for Jesse Justice.
A little revenge for earlier.
Jesse Justice, I love you. You are my favorite human being right now. ACT